In today's video, I'm going to show you a neat trick that you can use to replace your conditional formatting with Excel's custom formatting. Well, first off, let's define our phrases. Conditional formatting is this option, and custom formatting is this option. It's the one you use to show percentages, dates, etc. for your values. So now let's do a fun quiz. What do you think this formatting is based on? Custom or conditional formatting? That's right, it's custom formatting. What about this one? That's conditional formatting. And this one? Did you say conditional formatting? Well, I have a surprise for you. It's actually custom formatting. I'll show you how to do that in a second, but why would you want to use custom formatting instead of conditional formatting? Well, I tested the two different methods using 40,000 lines of data, and the custom formatting method was 3 times faster than conditional formatting. Not only that, but I actually find custom formatting faster to use, even if you want to build in thresholds like this one. I'm going to show you 4 different versions that you can use custom formatting instead of conditional formatting. In today's video, I'm going to show you the number 1 and number 2 versions, and in the next video, I'm going to show you how you can use any symbol of your choice for deviations and how to add thresholds to your deviations, so you don't show arrows for every single case, but only if it's above or below the threshold that you define. And each of these 4 cases uses custom formatting. And by custom formatting, I mean when you right mouse click and you go to Format Cells, Custom, and you use one of these, right? So it's just using this. It's not using conditional formatting at all. And now take a look at this. So this one has thresholds, right? So when I click on the formula, look how simple it is. Now I have the version with conditional formatting here. So in this example, I'm showing the same thing as I'm showing here, except that I'm using conditional formatting, so I'm using this one instead of custom formatting. Now take a look at the formula. It's more complex, and on top I have to go here to add a new rule, actually add 2 different rules to say how up arrows should be formatted and how down arrows should be formatted. Custom formatting is not just faster in terms of implementation, but it's also faster in terms of Excel's performance. The only thing you need to know is the logic behind custom formatting. And once that clicks, you'll see all the different opportunities that you have where you can improve the presentation of your reports. One thing you need to know, though, is the rules that go behind custom formatting. And I'm going to be honest with you, when I first came across custom formatting, I was trying to hide zeros in my report. And I came here and I saw these stuff here, these symbols, and I got scared. And then I Googled it and then found some code somewhere that I copied and pasted here. But once I took the time to actually understand the logic behind this, I realized it's very simple and it's really powerful. Now, my friend Michael is working on the ultimate custom formatting workbook that basically covers every single aspect to custom formatting. And he's trying to present this in a very user-friendly way. So this whole custom formatting is really a big topic, and it's not something I can cover in a short video. But what I'm going to cover it with you is just the basics, the building blocks of custom formatting to help you understand how we can get these effects. So the main logic is this. First argument in custom formatting, like you see here and here, they always have this separator. And the first argument is how positive numbers should be formatted. Then it's how negative numbers should be formatted. So that's where the code for it comes here. And then it's how zeros should be formatted. And last is how text should be formatted. Now, in this case, we're not going to bother with text formatting, so we only need these 3 arguments. And this, you can see here, there's the hashtag sign and the zero sign. They're basically just placeholders for numbers. The only difference is that the hashtag sign here, it's a variable placeholder, and zero is a fixed placeholder. Okay, but for now, just think of them as placeholders for number, any number. As an example, let's say that we want to have any plus numbers, any positive number that anyone inputs here, we want to show it as the word plus in there, not please, but plus. And we want to then put the number. Okay, so I'm just going to put that with a hashtag and I'll add a space here. Okay, so we want that number to say plus and then the number. Then now this argument was how negative values should be formatted. So I'm just going to put neg space, and for my number, I want to put it in brackets. Okay, so if it's negative, it should show it in brackets. What was this argument here? That was how zero values should be formatted. And I want to type the text hide in there. Okay, so I'm going to leave the last argument, which was for text, empty. And we're going to give this formatting to this cell, which is F9. Okay, I guess I have nothing in the cell. Now I'm going to put a positive number. I get +2. So it shows it to me as +2, even though the number inside is just 2. Now I put -2, it shows it as neg and then the bracket 2, even though the value in the cell is -2. Now if I put 0, I get hide, right? But the value in the cell is 0. I guess even though this looks like text, I could actually say this +2. Okay, so it took over the formatting of this and it shows it to me as +2. So if I take it away and go back to general, it's a 2, right? So it doesn't recognize it as text, even though it looks like text, but it's the number in there is actually a 0. Okay, if I wanted to hide really the zeros, what do I have to do? I'm going to press Control 1. That's the shortcut key to come here. I'm just going to delete this part, right? I'm just going to keep that argument here empty, not put anything in there. So even though the cell value is 0, it's not showing me anything. Okay, so that's how you can hide zeros. That was the basics of custom formatting. Then the other thing is that you can have more arguments in there. So here I put text in there, but you can add color, you can add other things that makes the numbers or the values not stick to the cell and so on. Okay, but right now what we want to work with is work with the colors, and you can see they always have these square brackets. That's just the basics. Let me switch to the draft version where I have nothing in. Okay, so these are just empty cells, and we are going to start with our custom formatting. First thing we need is, remember I have the up and down arrows in this case, right? I need those arrows. I can get them from insert symbol. I have them right here because I use them a lot, but you can find them under Arial here and they're geometric shapes. And just click on the ones that you want and press insert. Okay, that puts it on your spreadsheet. So I'm going to use this one and I also want this one. I'm just going to insert them somewhere in any cell. Let me just put them out of the way and paste them here. I'm going to use them later for my custom formatting. First thing I need to be able to use custom formatting is that I need to have numbers, right? Just like in the example that we did, I put a 2, I put a -2, I put a 0. They're all numbers. And then I can disguise these numbers to look like whatever I want. And that's why custom formatting works great for when you want to show deviations, like in this case. The first step is to do the calculations. I'm going to do actual minus previous year. Highlight this, press F2, Control Enter. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to need these symbols. So I'm going to come here and press Control C just to copy them. Now I'm going to highlight these where I want the custom formatting to apply and press Control 1. Now go to Custom, and here under General, we're going to start to do the rule that we saw before. So first argument was what? It was how positive numbers should be formatted, right? So I could say, well, put the positive numbers, just press paste here, but I could say put positive numbers as this value, right? And if it's a negative number, I'm just going to press paste again to paste the other one. Show negative numbers as this value, right? And for zero, show nothing. Okay, so if I do this and say okay, I get my symbols. And how do I add color to this? I can use the format that we saw before. So color is always in square brackets. So you have to find your square brackets on your keyboard. And for positive, let's say we want a green, and Excel has this built-in color. So these are going to be language sensitive because you have to translate green to green in your language. And that's probably going to work. And here red for negative. Okay, and I say okay. And I get my conditional formatting. Now, one thing I don't like about the green in Excel is the color is just really too bright. To get the full list of the different colors that are available, I put the link here. Okay, I'm going to show you where that takes you. It takes you to the Microsoft library that shows you the color indexes for the different colors available in custom formatting. A nicer green that I usually use is 10. And sometimes if I want it to be brighter, I use 43, and 50 is a nice one too. So you can see which one you like most. So let's use 10 instead of the green. And the code for it is you have to write, if you're in English, you have to write color 10. Okay, so that code you see there needs to be followed by color, but this is language sensitive, so you have to change this to the language of your Excel. And if you're not sure what it is, you can download the spreadsheet here, and when you open it in your language of Excel and you go to custom formatting, it will have translated it for you, so then you know what you need to use. Okay, so I do color 10 and I say okay, and now I get this darker green version here. Okay, so that was that. That was very simple. Now we're going to do another one. We're going to do percentages and we're going to show the deviation like this. So first off, to get the percentages, I'm going to do actual divided by previous year minus 1. Okay, we want to format this as a percentage, right? But that's something that we can do then in our custom formatting ourselves. But for now, we're calculating the deviation. Now what we want to do is to not just control the color of this, but to also add the symbol in there. So I'm going to copy these again. Now highlight this, press Control 1 to go back to custom formatting. Because I change it to percentage, I come to custom, it shows this one, which is great because I don't have to type it in anymore. I can already use that. First argument was how positive values need to be formatted. And here we want the positive values to have a green color. So I'm going to go with this color 10 again. I want the percentage there. And I also want that arrow in there. So I'm going to press Control V. And for this one, because it's positive, right, I want to use this arrow. Okay, now how negative numbers need to be formatted. I'm fine with Excel's default red color. I'm going to put minus 0%. Then I want the arrow again. So I'm going to press Control V. And that's the one that we need. And delete this one. And zeros I don't want to show at all. So I'm going to skip that. Let's see how that looks. Okay, that's not bad. So if you want to tweak this to give it more breathing space, so you want to move the numbers to one side of your cell and the arrows to the other side, what you can do is to use this code. If you put a space, it puts a manual space between them. So let me just put two spaces. You can see it expands it a little bit. But if you want it that no matter how big or wide your cell is. It always puts the numbers on one side and the arrows on the other side. What you can do is to use this syntax. I'm just going to get rid of these spaces here. The syntax is to put the star sign here. So the star sign is to repeat the next value. And if for the next value you put a space, it means it repeats the space until the size of the cell is reached. And then it puts this. Okay, so I'm just going to show you. It's difficult to explain this. It's easier when you see it. So right after the number, I'm going to put the star sign and put a space in there. And then press OK. And now you see what I mean. So if this is smaller, they come closer. If this is wider, they are further apart. That was how you can get number one and number two done. And in the next video, I'm going to show you how to set up number three and number four. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. If you like this video, don't forget to leave a thumbs up. And for more of these videos, why not subscribe to my channel for updates when new videos like this one come out?